Good afternoon, Lace Chap, and I'm Jonas, as many a truder. Welcome to Insurmountable, a game about ascending to the top of a mountain, or, to be precise, trying. Dying and leaving a very blue corpse, that's certainly an option too. In fact, to be honest, balance of probabilities, yeah, that's possibly the odds-on favourites. So, this is me. I'm a mountain climber, and that means I want to climb, there we go, that mountain between the two trees, right over there. Sorry, no, that's the wrong mountain. Okay, I meant this mountain. No, sorry, that's the wrong mountain too. Yeah, that mountain. That looks like the one that's got its own bloody northern lights over the top of it. Yeah, I need to get up there, and it's gonna be one hell of a trek. Basically, this game's kind of like a resource balancing roguelike, I think would be the best way to describe it. Because yeah, down at the bottom here, I've got various different meters I need to play off against each other. So, energy and sanity and body temperature and oxygen and health. If that one runs out, I die. The others, not so much, but if you run out of any meter, things are going to start getting hairy, shall we say. And the other meter, of course, is time. Time is frozen unless you're moving, so the game is paused, you've got plenty of time to think. If I want to go somewhere, the game will say, okay, that's going to take a certain amount of time to get there. It'll also eat a certain amount of energy, potentially a certain amount of sanity. If you ever want to check the exact numbers, they're always going to be up here. So yeah, your basic values are, you're going to lose a tiny bit of sanity every time you spend an hour moving. Your body temperature is going to go up. Your oxygen is going to go up, because right now I'm nice and low down. Oxygen is plentiful. Everything is just lovely. So you need to, like, you know, pick yourself a nice route. Just, you know, set various waypoints if you want to specify how you want to get somewhere. And one thing I really, really love, by the way, is I can't zoom the camera any further out than this. And on top of that, I can't move the camera away from my character. There is kind of a visibility system going on here. So I don't know what's further up the mountain beyond what I can see from where my character is. What's waiting for me up there? I don't know. I'm conceptually aware there might be like an icy waterfall in the distance. Looks like there might be an ice cliff up there, but I can't really be sure until I get there. So for the time being, I need to get myself all kitted out, because yes, these little circles are marking events. So, for example, down over here, that's going to be a cave. We could explore the cave, or we could take a little nap in it if we wanted to, but probably best as a starting point to go over to the generic event symbol. So, get over in this direction, and my character does a little bit of climbing, though obviously you can speed that up a little bit, and you can see there, as I'm just moseying along, I'm losing a tiny bit of energy, everything is under control. So we're just going to go and find ourselves a couple of events because, yeah, I'm going to be needing some equipment, shall we say. So here we go, event number one, and yes, events are very often about balancing different meters against each other. So, an intact tent, no one in sight, embers in the pit, still glowing, obviously being used. So, okay, we've already started, you know, robbing people potentially. I lose a bit of sanity because I'm doing some robbing, or I say, no, I'm better than that. I'm not better than that. All right, I'm going to be glad I robbed this place when I'm further up the mountain. Basically, screw you. So I plunder it, find some good stuff, so I get myself heavy boots. Good, that's a bit of equipment that's really bloody useful. So yeah, apparently I didn't bother coming with any equipment or anything. So, well, aside from gloves, I did bring some gloves. So, the character I'm playing as, the adventurer, she's got herself minus 10 energy cost on all terrain. So, no matter what I'm doing, whether I'm walking or climbing or whatever, I get to do it for a tiny bit less energy than any other character would. Because, yeah, there are like three classes of adventurers, the basic one. And these boots, meanwhile, are going to be better on stone. So, okay. As long as I'm standing on stone, then even less energy cost. I can move across stone pretty bloody easily. I also start with a tent, so I can rest in that when I need a bit of a nap, and some canned food if I need some energy in a hurry. But no need to worry about that yet. So yeah, that used some energy, it cost me some sanity, and time is moving on too. Now, there's nothing to stop me just saying, hey, please walk to the top of the mountain, but as you may have guessed, yeah, I'm gonna run out of energy before I get there, hence when the green line turns red. So generally, it's probably not a good idea to attempt all of that in one go. As I say, things are gonna start going wrong if you try and continue walking on zero energy. You can, but yeah, things are gonna get weird. It's a bit like the Curious Expedition in that regard. What I can see, however, is yes, if I wanted to get right up to the summit, the fastest way would be to just go along here, then up there, then around. But that doesn't mean that's the only route. You can see that would mean leaving aside a whole bunch of events. Like, you know, there's a little treasure chest or something over there. If I was to go over there, that would get me a nice chest, but it might be massively out of the way. So yeah, so if I want to go up there, then I want to get up to here. Yeah, I pretty much have to double back on myself. So some stuff is just really out of the way because I just can't climb up sheer rock. Well, sometimes you can, but apparently just that bit you can't. So that treasure chest, that's just a no-go. Rather, if I did go over there, that would be very difficult, very much out of the way. Now, this treasure chest, I need to go over in this direction anyway. So I feel like that wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. And if I wanted to go over to here, yeah, that's a little shrine that generally tops up a meter. But my meats are pretty good right now. Yeah, I'm just going to head in this direction and just go and grab that. Because this is mostly flat and it's all stone. All right, I'm good at walking over stone. So as a result of that, this here, this is going to work for me. I've also got special abilities you can see down over here. So yes, sprint. I can activate once every 24 hours. It's active for 3 hours and it means time cost on all terrain goes down. So if I want to get somewhere in a hurry, that's marvelous. And okay, I really need to stop just robbing other people's tents, but whatever. Okay, but today this is a ruined camp, so I'm not losing sanity because I'm not robbing anyone. Instead, I'm just choosing a certain amount of time to give up. Well, to be honest, do a thorough search. All right, got plenty of time. So 2 vacuum flasks filled with tea. Marvelous. Hot tea is great. If I get cold further up the mountain, which is going to happen, I can use that to get a little bit more toasty. Also, events give you XP. XP gives you level ups. Level ups give you perks. So here we go. Choice of 3. Flat terrain expert. So, okay. Minus 0.5 cost on all terrain. So, okay, if I'm just walking across a flat, that's going to be good, regardless of whether it's like made of stone, ice, or snow, which are the 3 terrain types. Or gain more experience for events in the night, but night is dangerous. Or alternatively, gain sanity when you use a consumable item, so the tea or the canned goods I brought with me. I feel like, yeah, light steps. Let's just go for that for now. So less energy when I'm just walking along. So that there, that's a new perk I've just picked up. Everything is absolutely lovely. And yes, for the time being, we're also in good condition. Today, the weather is good. Tomorrow, the weather's going to be great too. That's not going to last forever though. And yeah, because I can't really zoom out, sometimes it can be a bit hard to figure out, like, you know, where an event actually is precisely. I think there might be, yeah, I'm not sure if that's actually on this hex or not. So sometimes you want to set out and then reevaluate while you're going. If I was to go here, then say up to here, that's doubling back on myself. That's a bit of a waste. And no, get rid of that. I'm just going to leave the cave. Then again, I say leave the cave. It's kind of almost night because I just spent a lot of time just, you know, ransacking. So, okay, I'm going to hit night the moment I hit the cave. That's not the worst thing in the world because I know I've got myself a... Oh. Sometimes you run into random events too. Okay, so there's some dead people here. That's going to get me tons of XP, but unfortunately, I'm going to go slightly mad from all of the looting. There's another level up. That's lovely. So, okay. Careful steps. So, spend more time when moving, but ignores dangerous terrain. So, this is an active ability I can activate. So, once every 24 hours, last 4 hours, plus 100% time cost on all terrain. But it means, okay, so I go really slowly, but if there's difficult terrain, I know I won't run into anything that, like, you know, might kill me. Light step 2, so, okay, even more reduction energy cost. That's probably not a bad idea. Or another active ability, Stone Mastery. So I can activate that. For 6 hours, I'm going to be really, really effective on stone. Now, there's going to be more stone down the bottom of the mountain, I assume. And yeah, more snow and ice up top. Ooh, those are all very good, but I'm just going to take light steps 2 for now. That's a good investment immediately. So, okay, keep on keeping on. Everything's fine. And yeah, if I wanted to, I could start sprinting, but I feel like we are okay for now. Okay, that just means I can make a lot of progress faster, which I should probably start doing because, you know, you get a couple of nice little days to kick you off at the beginning of your adventure. That ain't necessarily going to last. So nothing in this cave to explore. Instead, just lie down and sleep. I do not need my actual, tent or anything. That's all absolutely fine because, yeah, inside the cave, you've got shelter. I do have a tent, of course, but it's only got so many uses. It gets damaged by the weather or whatever. So Yeah, we're going to sleep for a long time. That's going to get me all of my energy back. And because the cave is nice and sheltered and we're nice and low down, I'm not going to get cold. Everything is just lovely. So it is now, yes, the following morning, except officially, it's still night. Visibility is not so hot in the middle of the night. At the moment, it's okay, but yeah, just always check your notes here. It's night right now, so I'm going to start getting colder when I move. So this might be a good time to activate Sprint, because then I can kind of offset that ability by going nice and fast. Now, I do want to get over to, yes, this little treasure chest. So we're going over there, and I'm getting colder, but I'm offsetting that by sprinting, and also I'm just, you know, making fast progress here. So get down over here. Might be able to get some good stuff right here, so unknown fruit. Okay, eat as many as I can. Don't know what's going to happen. Just try one, or ignore them. I feel like try one. I'm going to try one and see what happens. So, okay, they're exotic, they re-energize me. And I was about to grab more, but my stomach says no. So I lose a tiny bit of sanity, but I gain some XP. I gain a tiny bit of energy. You know what? That's fine. That's all under control. And yeah, watch out because, yeah, bear in mind, you can very easily just not see an event because it is literally hidden from you. So it does pay sometimes to take small steps and just reevaluate where you are and what's going on. And do I really want to do that? Climbing is a bit difficult on the old everything, and yeah, it's going to be day momentarily. So yeah, the fastest way would just be to clamber down. My energy's looking okay for now. Hopefully this event will get me something good. The bare minimum, it will get me XP. There is a goat herd. Okay, he beckons me over. Hello, Mr. Goat Herd. So gives me... Okay, he just gave me a free climbing axe. So I can now climb up, yeah, sheer stuff way faster. Okay, now that... That's good. Does that go in the hand? Yes, that goes in the hand over there. John, it goes where the axe symbol is. Dear, oh flippin' dear. Okay, so now I can climb way faster. Because, yeah, now I can go up that and it takes, like, no time whatsoever. So that there, that was a good thing. Could go up to the shrine. Yeah, that symbol generally means shrine. Shrine means, hey, we're going to fill up one of your meters. I mean, that's a bit out of the way. Yeah, that's kind of retracing my steps. Because if I want to go from there up to here... Yeah, there's no way around that way. I'm going to ignore that shrine, because it's really out of the way. Is there anything else around here? There might have been something like back the other way. Yeah, there was like a treasure chest or something. I can't really see very well, so... I'm just going to go over to here. And yeah, that's the point where a day will hit. So, I like the UI. The UI is very clean, very clear. You always know what's going on. You can check any active effects in the environment. You know, the line's very clear about what's happening in the world. And momentarily, there we go. It is now suddenly day. It is nice, and it's going to be nice again tomorrow. Okay, I've got another good day here. But this is my first big challenge. It is now going to be difficult to climb. Just keep in mind, yeah, climbing is always going to be tricky. And sometimes, yes, the direct route is not the best. This is why you want to do multiple clicks. Because when you tell the game to go somewhere, it will go the most direct route. It would just say, hey, you want to get up there? That's fine, just get up there. But climbing is difficult, it's tiring. So, yeah, like, consider that amount of energy versus here, 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 and then here. That is way less energy to do the same ascent. So that there, that's what you want to be doing. So, yeah, that is absolutely a-okay. Just clamp up, keep an eye out for any other events or anything around here. Looks pretty clear for the time being, though it looks like also there might be... Could I actually get up here? Okay, hang on. Can I just get up? Okay, so there's multiple paths. And yeah, this does happen on occasion. There is 100% another path up there. If I wanted to go up to here. Yeah, you can always check whether there is a way forward. Some of this is a bit dangerous. Yellow marks. Hey, be careful. You might get a random danger event over here. But if I go that way. I'm going to be honest. I feel like... Yeah, going like here up to the shrine up here. And then looping over to... here-ish. I mean, that's a bit dangerous too, but I feel like that's got to be the better way to go. Let's just start going over there, and there's a cave. Because if I hit night, I could just go to that cave, then I don't need to use my tent. Though, yeah, the advantage of a tent, of course, is you can do it anywhere. And, yeah, now it's 21 hours till I can next use my sprint ability. But I'm looking good in terms of temperature. Sanity's looking bit on the low side, some wild herbs. So, okay. Climb down to get herbs. That's a lot of energy. Or continue my journey. What do the herbs do, precisely? Gone moldy, still gain a handful of them. That is plus one a herb, together with some XP. Sanity up, and health down by one. Okay, so I'm just doing mountain drugs at this point. That's fine. And level up two. So steep climber, active ability, master climber, reduce energy cost on all terrain for 3 hours. So that sounds pretty useful, I'll admit. Or reduce sanity loss in events, and again, sanity when I eat items. No, I'm going to take master climber. That seems like a sensible sort of a thing to possess as, you know, a special ability, especially as, ooh. Yeah, these rocks. These are more dangerous rocks, I believe. Yeah, here we go. Smooth rock is fine. If a thing is bobbly, that means it's more dangerous. So, like, you know, there's normal rock, bobbly rock, normal snow, kind of bobbly snow, normal ice, and jaggedy ice. So watch out for all of that. Now, I need to go up anyway. So, you know what? As I'm going to be doing a little bit of climbing right over here, I may as well activate this. So I'm going to activate Master Climber, and then I'm just going to go straight up here, and yeah, that is energy cost of all terrain. So I can climb way more effectively up here. So that's only a tiny bit of energy. If I actually go the long way around, that's more effective, but it's probably slower. Hang on. So that would take me to about there. If I just go up the direct route. Wow. Okay, so I can literally just climb up here. And that uses a fair whack of energy if I go the longer way round. But I do therefore avoid the nasty rocks. That's tricky. So yeah, I can avoid the nasty rocks by spending a bunch of energy doing a difficult climb. Or I can just say, screw it, I'm going to go over all the dangerous rocks to get that. Okay, you know what? I'll take the energy cost and I'll just climb up. Because I've got that special ice axe. I've got my climbing ability in play. Let's just do that. All right, I'm going to avoid the dangerous bobbly rocks and just make sure there's nothing else around here. And yeah, now I'm over here, I can see around this corner a bit better. I don't see much, but I do see two treasure chests up here. So yeah, this was a bit bad on the old energy front, but a shrine and health or energy. There we go. I've got my energy back. So that shrine was very much worth going to. Now, ultimately, probably I want to start over. Ooh. If I go to here first, can I get to... Wait, hang on. How do I get to... Can I get to here? No. Okay, that's impassable. So one way or another, I've got to go over some dangerous rocks. So that's fine. It is you I want to go to ultimately. Head over in that direction. So yeah, a random dangerous event might occur because these are just dangerous rocks. That's fine. That's legit. I've got my climbing axe thanks to that lovely event earlier. So far, looks like we are golden. Double cave, in fact, triple cave over there. Marvelous. Down over here. And if we're lucky, provision. So there is something behind a huge boulder. Push the boulder aside if you want to just Chris Redfield it up a bit. Use a branch. Outcome unknown. That's a lot of energy. I'll use a branch, but something's going to happen. So boulder falls to one side. That worked out well. I'm guessing it could have gone worse. So XP together with oxygen tank. Good. Good, good, good. Yeah, by the way, right now, yeah, the whole oxygen situation is fine. That's not going to last. Apparently there's a thing called like the dead zone or the death zone or something where like, you know, the oxygen gets a bit thin way up there. So once we get up to that, that's going to be more of a problem actually. So, aha, secret hidden thing I didn't see before. So we're going over there, obviously. Then bit of a dangerous path over here. In fact, loads of stuff over here. This is all golden. I'll take all of this. So, oh, there's an attack. Not on me, though. Okay, that's absolutely fine. It is the hunter struggling with a cougar. So his face is streaked with blood. I can help him at a massive cost of energy. I can steal his stuff. Wow. Or I can just continue. I'm going to be honest, that's a lot of energy to give up. But if I do that, maybe he'll give me something. And okay, we're kind of halfway through the day. We can bed down pretty soon anyway. There are caves nearby. Screw it. I'm going to help him out. So I just decided to tackle a cougar. Excellent. And he's going to give me something for that. And accept the gift. It is XP and another cup of tea. Well, isn't that just the best thing of all? Honestly, I'm swimming in tea right now. Okay, keep that in mind. My energy is now low. How far away is that, by the way? Honestly, not too bad. I can get to this right now. Yeah, let's get over to that immediately. Yeah, there's a whole bunch of stuff I can get. Then we should probably beeline to a cave. So some wild herbs, even more of them. I've kind of got them already, and that's a lot of energy. Yeah, we're gonna have to leave that, unfortunately. So just head over here instead. Clambering down can be a bit expensive on the old energy, but we should be okay. And it's another goat herd, but this one is nowhere near as nice. Instead, he just, you know, wishes me good luck and then wanders off. So get some XP, get a tiny bit of sanity back because I ran into a human. So was that worth the cost of energy? Maybe, maybe not. Oh, blimey, that's a bit. That was a bit much. Okay, if I loop round to the top here. Okay. Yeah, same deal again. That shrine could get me something good, but I need to cross dangerous rocks to get up there, unless I'm willing to sacrifice a lot of energy to go direct. No. I'm going to try and go... What's the safest way here? Over to here. Yeah, I just need to go over the dangerous rocks if I want to go up to that shrine, which I kind of do, to be honest. So we accept a bad thing might happen while I'm just on the move right now. Because, yes, I'm going over. Yep, here we go. That's what can happen. A red interrupt event. So there's some loose stones. One of them hits me. I've just lost a tiny amount of health. So you know what? That was a risk. I knew it could happen. In fact, I probably should have clambered up to here first. That was safer. And we've got ourselves a shrine. So she is offering me health or warmth. To be honest, both of them are kind of garbage. I was hoping for energy, but I guess I'll take a health top up. So all of that was for nothing, to be honest. Okay. There is another event over there. Big shiny event. Obviously, big shiny events are good. Not too difficult to get to over here. But for the time being, time is getting on. It's going to be night soonish. There are two caves next to each other, which means, once again, yeah, I don't need to use my actual, tent in my inventory. So that's all fine. And in the morning, I'll have my abilities broadly ready to go. Because, yeah, it is actually a 24-hour clock, even though it looks like a normal clock. Like, you know what I mean? It's a clock. Ah, but on this occasion, there might be something in the cave. I'll give it a look-see, sure. So, hundreds of fireflies. Fascinating. There we go. Bit of sanity, bit of XP. Not going to complain at all. And honestly, I may as well lie down to sleep here. And yeah, that's going to use up some time and get me energy back. So we are going to sleep. So kind of wasting a bit of the day. But I know tomorrow's going to be fine in terms of weather. But now it's going to be, yes, dark. Now I could just go around the corner to... Well, there's something right here. To be honest, I could just go to this. Yeah, why not? And that is a bag. Okay, faded prints from, I don't know, a goat. I was about to say horse, but up a mountain? Probably not. Well, there are some herbs, so I've got more sanity herbs here. Yeah, gather items when you're down low on the mountain. You're going to be needing them later, and oh, blimey. Bit of a risky cave to get to here, but there is also a smell I could follow. Yeah, go on, why not? And nothing aside from fur and bones. Get a bit of XP for being bold anyway. Lie down and sleep. And do I want a... Yeah, just a short sleep to get me to the beginning of the next day. That's going to get me my energy back. And because it's nice and sheltered, get my body temperature up. And on top of that, I can level up. Lovely. Now, ooh. Okay, tomorrow's a storm. So tomorrow things are going to start getting nasty. Open-minded, increase sanity gain during events, alternatively on the edge. Prevent critical interruption events for 4 hours. So, okay. In the event that I run out of a meter and things are going to start killing me, I can, yeah, activate on the edge. That's a good emergency backup. Or reduce energy cost on snow. I'm going to take on the edge. So that's a new active ability. In the event things are going completely wrong, that would not hurt. No, how difficult to get to you. Honestly, I'd rather, avoid that and then go this sort of a path. That's going to use up not much energy, really. So just a tiny bit of difficult stone to cross. Ignore that cave down under there. Now, that cave could have had an event in it, but some caves do, some caves don't. It's probably not worth the trouble, to be honest. So just loopy roundy to here and see what this is. Because it is going sparkle, sparkle, which is probably a good sign that I want to go and visit it. There is a melody. So, okay, music coming from inside the mountain. Yes, the backstory is you're on a mysterious island which shouldn't, like, exist or have mountains on it or something. So, like, there might be something mystical going on in the mountain. It's kind of unclear. So, XP and a bit of sanity back. Okay, I've fully recovered from... Well, actually, to be honest, I feel like... If you hear music coming from inside the mountain, that shouldn't make you more sane. That should make you, like, much less sane. So, okay. If I go over there, that's kind of doubling back on myself a little bit. That's a long way to go. That's a lot of energy, a lot of time wasted. So we're going to leave that one be and just make our run to... Maybe not to that. If I go here... Yeah, there we go. Slightly longer way round, but it does mean I avoid all the rest of it. Now, do I want to activate any of my abilities? I mean, Master Climber does appear to be, all-terrain... I'll save that for... Well, actually, what's coming up? Well, there's some stuff coming up over there. Where am I ultimately going? Yeah, I feel like there might be some bigger climbing coming up. So I'm just going to start sprinting now to make a bit of progress. So we're just going to go in that direction. So I should avoid any trouble, though. Just keep your eyes out because, yeah, look over there. There's actually a bit of treasure in that part of the world. Do I want to divert to potentially get... an item. Because if it's just some more tea, that's not so good. But if it turns out to be, say, some form of equipment, that'd be good. Honestly, it's barely out of the way at all, and it's a pretty safe bit of, path. I'm just going to head over there. And I am sprinting right now, so yeah, I'm making good time. It's a good time to do a bit of a diversion, because I'm going very fast, which I can do, because I am an adventurer. Huzzah. There is an icefall. So, okay, several tents. Who set up camp here? Approach the camp, check the slope, go to the first tent. Okay. This is interesting. I mean, I guess I'll go to the camp. Don't really know which way this goes. So, your circulation plummets. You manage to... Oh, okay. Something just went really, really badly wrong. I was distracted for a second. Something hits me on the head. There is blood. Okay, so I've gained XP, but lost, like, you know, blood. Which is probably not... Oh, it took me a while to bandage my head, too. Okay, so that one, that screwed me over. Because sometimes on the mountain, things just gonna, you know, screw you over. Now, if I go over there, that's going to get me to, a shrine. Which might help me. Then there's a cave. You know what? That's gonna work out nicely. The shrine gets me to night... Then we just nip over to the cave, sort that out. That is a random event. There's another cave down over there. To be honest, I should probably, get into the cave, sleep, and then do a bit of, heavy climbing in this direction in the morning. Because we're getting up to steeper bits and pieces here. There's night. There is a golden eagle. Magnificent. So, sanity or warmth? I mean, I'm already max temperature, so I guess I'll take some eagle sanity. Right, get down over here. Fast as you like, because, now I'm getting cold fast, because it's night. Get to the cave, sleep in the cave. Because, yes, I do actually have a special, tent, which has got three uses. But so far, I've not had to use it, which is probably good news. So, lie down and sleep. Yep, there is no special event here. So, sleep until almost morning. That's fine. Gets me all my energy back. We're golden. Things down in this part of the world, all fine. For the most part, all I'm doing is just, trying to gather equipment and stuff. Because things are going to be nastier if I go a little bit further up. 5 hours left until I can sprint. Do I have any other way forward? This looks fine for the time being. I'm just going to move in this direction. Get a bit of a better view as to what's going on. That's a cave down over there. There's another shrine right there, so random 2 meters could be filled up. There's dawn, and yep, there's the storm. and the music suddenly gets a bit ominous. So we got storm right now, tomorrow, cold. Okay, check what's going on here. Storm. It is now going to be 20% slower and 20% more energy intensive to do everything. So, okay. Fascinating. And on top of that, yeah, this map in general has sturdy rocks, so stone is easy to cross, but blizzard. When it's cold, it's really cold, so the tea is going to start being useful tomorrow when the cold sets in. So yeah, I can just keep going, but it's going to start being more and more difficult. If I want to get up there, that's going to be a difficult climb, potentially. If I want to get over there, by the way, can I just go to here then? Oh, hang on. Yeah, there's no way through, is there? Yeah, looks like there's no way through here at all. If I want to go that way, then yeah, I need to climb that. Okay. Probably best, as we're in a storm, to activate Master Climber pretty soon. So just get over here. And as soon as we're right by this, just to make sure we get the maximum use out of it, activate Master Climber mode. So that is now on. And yeah, I want to go over to this here shrine. So that's going to make it much easier for me to climb it, even though there's a storm on. That's going to make life more manageable. So little shrine is going to be giving me sanity or energy. Okay, there we go. Topped up the energy. Now, if I want to go straight up, that's going to be a bit expensive. Probably best to go... Yeah, I'll take a risk on this one tiny bit of rock just to skip all of this. Doesn't look like there's anything down there to me. So yeah, let's just... climb up while I'm under the effect of Master Climber. So get up here. No trouble there. Straight up to the top. And yeah, till tomorrow, the weather's just going to be what it is. So okay. Stone plaque. Bit of energy. Yeah, go on. Dig it up. And what have we got? Characters etched in stone. Some kind of writing system. You regret you can't read it. Must have been a civilization here long ago. What could have led to their downfall? Well, possibly living on the side of a cocking mountain. It gets very bloody cold. But on the other hand, there's something down below. So, fur gloves. Okay, interesting. So, right now my existing gloves are climbing gloves. So, 10% energy cost to all terrain. If it gets cold, however, I've now got toasty gloves to put on instead. Okay, bit of a shame I've got duplicates, but yeah, when the cold sets in tomorrow, I might want to switch over to that. That potentially could be useful. Okay, how many ways do we have up here? Because I can see there's something up there. Yeah, okay, there's two different ways. There is what looks like a straight up ice climb over in this direction. That is basically, okay, it's non-stop dangerous. Absolute non-stop dangerous. This here looks safer, and there's something good going on route. Is there any other way I can... No, this is a bit narrow. I'm just going up the only available path here. So this is going to be expensive on the old energy, but I guess we just have to hope for a shrine. And, oh, rough stone, unfortunately. So I have got... Uh-oh. Oh, dear. 24 hours of high energy cost. Oh dear. Now how much is it going to cost to get up there? More than it did. Okay. I could just start sprinting. That's going to mean I move faster, but it's not going to save me energy. It's just going to mean time. I can do more with my time, but I kind of don't want that because I'd rather... Oh, blimey. Well, okay. I could just... wait out the day, but it's going to be cold tomorrow. Screw it. I just have to push on. Bad luck. So I've sprained my ankle. This is not great. I'm losing energy really fast now. And as I say, you don't want to have no energy. Bad call. You can keep going, but it's not necessarily going to end well for you. Still, on the plus side, I've now reached the Northern Lights, which gets me some sanity back. And, I mean, they're already kind of there. Okay, level up. What can I do here? Reduce time cost, all terrain. Increased oxygen per hour. Careful steps. Spend more time when moving. Ignores dangerous terrain. Ooh. That's interesting. Yeah, you know what? Just in case I run into a really dangerous area again, let's keep that in my back pocket. Now, do I want to go up there? That is... Well, that's dangerous. That's dangerous terrain right there. What else is there over here, by the way? If I want to get up to there... Yeah, there's a path over in this direction, up top here, with some treasure on it. So I may as well go over there while I'm passing by. What else have I got if I want to go over here? Not too much dangerous, to be honest. Honestly, the most dangerous stuff is right here. So I'm going to go to this spot right now. And as soon as I get close by to this, I'm now going to... Ooh, careful steps does double the time. I mean, that's kind of good. Because, yeah, doubling time is now a positive thing for me. I want double time because I need to recover from a sprained ankle. The more time I spend, the better. I'm activating that. So now I'm going to very slowly go in this direction. But I know I'm safe from all of these dangerous locations. And there's also something... up there. Fairly generic event. This is a generic event too, but whatever. I mean, I might want to... Okay, I've got like 2 more hours of this. Okay, no sign of a cave. We need to use the tent for the first time. So another leather bag. Have a bit of a look-see what we got here. More herbs. I'm swimming in herbs right now, so if sanity's a problem, I can sort it out. Now, where are we going to hit? There's night. Okay, while I'm still under the effect of... I am not under the effect of this. I think it's worn off. Okay, we're going to go down over here until we hit night, and we're going to hope that nothing bad happens, even though these are dangerous rocks. Okay, we're fine. There's night. And yes, welcome to night, because in night proper, when it's not morning, you can't see anymore. Like, visibility's done properly, like, I can't see anything. I'm going to go a little bit further right now, because I know this is the direction I want to go in. And then I'm probably going to snuggle up for the night. So, go into my sleep menu. I've got a tent. So, I can just not use my tent, but bad call. I'm going to get very cold. Use the damn tent. Get a nice long sleep in. That'll bring me to... morning, and that's going to get me a ton of energy back, but it is a use of my tent. I've only got a certain number of uses, so okay, everything's fine. It's all under control now. It should be, yeah, about morning. This is probably where I want to go, and yeah, right now my special thing should wear off shortly. 5 hours till my sprained ankle goes away. I'm now in the death zone. Okay, so oxygen's now going to be trickier to deal with. Okay, options. Options, options, options. I can take a moment to patch myself up to get my health back up, my sanity too. Or I can say, huzzah, for 8 hours I shall just burst forward because I'm getting closer. Or I can say, 24 hours I gain bonus oxygen while I'm moving. Because in the death zone, things are bad. Yes, when I'm moving, oxygen is now going down. Okay, probably take it slow. Let's, like, you know, speed things up a bit here because I now need to keep things moving. Okay, one special thing, a wreck. There has been a plane crash. That's cool. The problem is every time I spend time now, I'm also sacrificing oxygen because I literally can't breathe. And it's cold as well because, oh yeah. Good stuff going on right here. I'm just going to take a quick look, not a proper look. It's day, equipment, and crampons. Okay, so boots. 20% energy cost on ice. So my existing boots were 10% on stone versus 20% on ice. I feel like there's going to be more ice going forward. And also, it's cold today. Keep my existing gloves on for now. Remember, I do have... the rest of it. And I can sort out sanity and heat and a bit of energy when I want to. Okay. What's going to be the best way to go? Probably straight over. Oh, blimey heck. Well, that's going to be fun, isn't it? Yes. I mean, I could go down over to that. That feels like a bit of a way out of the way. Yeah, we're just going to go in this direction. I think it might be time to activate Master Climber. Though, to be honest, there's a lot more climbing up ahead. Yeah, I think we leave Master Climber for now. How long until this wears off, by the way? 1.3 hours. Okay, we're almost over my sprained ankle. I'm just going to have to hope that this works out safely, or if it doesn't, I just lose like one of health and not anything more crippling. Darn it, rough stone. Okay, just health. No 24-hour debuff. I am okay with that. That's absolutely fine. Okay, final plateau before we hit the big lads over here. Oxygen is holding together for now. Obviously, yeah, I'm going over towards the treasure chest. See what we can find right over here. And temporary buffs. Yes, I have now officially got over my sprained ankle. Search the tents, quick look around, and yeah, oxygen's going to start being a problem. Just a quick look, please, and spare tent. Okay, now that's good, but... Okay, slight issue. I think we're going to have to leave some of this behind, unfortunately, because... okay, this is all fascinating. Everything's a-okay. Put you in there, bring you there. There we go, we've Resident Evil 4'd it, it's all under control. Now there's also a shrine over there. And then another event next to it. If I do that, then I go up here. There is a path that doesn't involve a direct complete ascent. And there's two shrines on the way. Hadn't realized that a second ago. I feel like that's going to be the right way to go. And I'm going to start sprinting. Stop, please. Just stop. Yeah, I'm going to sprint. Let's get something going on here. Because sprinting also boosts my body temperature, which is really useful. So now my body temperature should be a bit more under control. Okay, this is going to be fine. I see there's some dangerous stuff over here. But I do have Master Climber off cooldown. So... one event, if we're lucky, good shrine. We have got a cloaked mountaineer. He wants some tea. He can have some tea and get some sanity and some XP and one shrine. That's fine. I've got spare tea. The eagle's showing up again. Sanity or warmth? I would have rather had, you know, oxygen or energy, but I'll take it, I guess. Right, that's... oh, blimey, that's a long way to go. That's literally going to burn out my energy. I mean, there is a cave right there. The problem is, I've only got a certain number of hours of preserve your breath. So right now, I'm not losing oxygen as fast as I will be. So this is the point in the dead zone. You start thinking, hey, maybe I do want to, like, you know, work through the night. Because if I don't, I might just die. So if I go up to here... and then to there. Okay, that uses a fair whack of energy. If I just go directly, that uses up all my energy. Okay, how dangerous is this route? It's quite dangerous. But if I go... ooh. Okay. Do I want to use... yeah, go careful. I can't afford to anymore. I think it would be too dangerous to do so. Just head in this direction. I'm going to go to the cave. There might be an event in the cave. If there's not, I could just sleep in the cave. I mean, I need energy anyway. I mean, to be honest, I desperately need energy. So just go up to the cave, please. Okay, have a look, see what we got here. And yeah, explore the tunnel. Okay, so it's really dark. And I don't have a torch, so I have to step into the darkness. I can't back out now. And... okay, can't go any further. I gained some XP. Honestly, that's fine. And I need to get my energy back, so I need to have a long sleep. So... oh, that's gonna cost me... yeah. Now, being in a cave costs me body temperature. Because I'm a higher up, you can always keep an eye on your, yeah... altitude right there. So anything over 6,000 meters is death zone. Okay, I do have tea. The oxygen worries me a bit, but I desperately need energy. All right, I'm just trying to balance. This is where things start getting a bit terrifying, actually. Level up, by the way. So enthusiasm, whenever you reach a... what's a POI? Is that an event? Is that a point of interest? Is that what they are? I think that's what they are. So, honestly, that's probably a good thing. Yeah, I'll take enthusiasm. So now, hopefully, I gain a tiny amount of interest every time I hit something. And going up this, I feel like this is going to be the right way to go. Yeah, Master Climber. Have to do that. Tomorrow's going to be... Oh, tomorrow it's going to be back to clear. Okay, good conditions. Right there. So right now I'm losing a lot of temperature. It's going to be better later. Okay, I'm going to activate Master Climber. All right, that's going to be active for a while. And then we're just going. Can I just go up to here, then here? Yeah, if I do that, that's going to be a bit of energy. If I go direct... That looks like it's less to me, actually. So I'm just going to do that. I'm just going to go up the most direct route, especially as it's actually safer because I'm avoiding some dangerous rocks. So, okay. That is a shrine. Hopefully that gets me a tiny bit of, energy because I'm enthusiastic. So just keep on keeping on. Here we go, shrine. And there's... Ooh! Okay, there's a bloke here. So, he's brought me some tea back again. Or he's offering me tea and herbs. Or tea and a torch. Okay. I mean, if I run into a cave, the torch would be good. Yeah, I'll take the tea and the torch. Oh, the torch is quite big. Increased light radius. Ah, okay, so it can be used in events. It can be used in general. You know what? I might just use the oxygen, plus 45 oxygen. It's out of 100. That would almost fill me up anyway. To be honest, yeah, just use it. Yeah, just use it now. That's absolutely fine. And items can't be used. Oh, sorry, I can't use it during an event thing. That's a-okay. Leave behind my fur gloves, to be honest. Put that there. That's under control. Confirm all that. Screw the gloves. We're just going to have to make do. And he smiles, bows. There's some XP and a bit of sanity anyway. Okay, just check what the actual shrine is before we make any more decisions about what we're doing next. And sanity, energy. Not the best time for it, but I'll take it. I would have liked oxygen, but maybe shrines can't give you that. So, okay. Oh, here's where life gets interesting. There's the summit, right there. There is another secondary peak, right there with some stuff on it. But it would take me time and oxygen to go there. There are many approaches to this thing. I mean, there's another treasure chest right there. There's a shrine right there. If I just try and go straight up, I can do it, but it's gonna burn, like, all my energy to do so. It's probably not the most efficient way to do it. Do I want to go to this anyway? I feel like I want to go to this anyway. That cost me, like, no energy. There might be some good stuff going on there. Plus, I think, like, it's probably a bad idea to, like, you know, go out at night. I might wait for tomorrow, because tomorrow it's not cold anymore. Tomorrow, we've got good conditions. We're going to be fine. Yeah, there we go. Daybreak, clear. Everything's lovely. It is a lonely grave. Okay. So, loot or reflect and pray? No, let's loot. And what are we going to do here? So, another mountaineer. So, take some equipment. Leave it to sit. No, I'm taking the equipment, damn it. And, okay. Continue my journey. Going to cost me a bit of... I'm really worried by the oxygen situation. Oxygen mask! Okay, well, yes. Kind of needed that, actually. Shove that right on there. Marvelous. And you know what? Honestly, go here and just use that right now. Oxygen bottle, use it. Okay, I've now got my oxygen back. And use this to drink some hot tea. I'm not in a bad place for the climb right now. Honestly, for the big climb to the summit, we're in good shape. And when I say the big climb... You don't win by getting to the summit. You have to get to a safe zone a bit down the mountain first. This is going to be very difficult to do. Okay, where's that, by the way? That is... Okay, I see a couple of events over here. And unfortunately, I don't have Master Climber available to me. Okay, if I go to here, then to here, then to here. Do this careful-like. That's not so bad. I'm going to start by doing that. In terms of energy, that's not so much usage. So just clamber up in that direction. All right, just be ready. And if need be, I've got on the edge. Okay, we're fine. There's a couple of things around here. I know I saw something around the corner. Yeah, there we go. So don't just sprint straight at the summit. Maybe go straight over here. That's not so bad, to be honest. Just go to the shrine. The shrine, if it could give me energy, would be ideal. The day's already actually... Ooh. I'm a bit worried by how fast the day's getting away from me here. It is a shrine. Health or warmth? I'll take the health, just in case. And now, there it is. There's the summit. And of course, you can just, you know... look back, it's got a really nice sense of scale, this game. Because you can just zoom straight into your explorer and just, you know, you feel tiny. You feel like you're a really tiny thing, climbing a really big thing. It's just, it's got a lovely sense of scale to it. I do appreciate that. If I just wanted to make a sprint at the summit right now. Oh, probably a bad idea, lads. No, 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 no. Round the outside. Round the outside, and not that bit, over to here, up to here. Yeah, that's the more sensible option. That's the option right there. Okay, we're gonna make it. All right, up we go. Just clamber up to here. We should be golden. There is a special magic event right there, and we have flipping done it. The summit, and yes, you may notice it says the first summit. Yeah, so about that. So, get a bunch of XP, I'll lay a flag down, everything is good. Yes, first things first, I need to get out of here. And getting out of here can be tricky too, by the way. If I just want to go here, that would be... Oh, that wouldn't be the easiest thing in the world. Yes, plotting your route going down can be difficult, but screw it. Just see what this... gives me. It's a sparkly event, so I should probably check it out as best we can. I can also sprint. It's also nearly time for a bit of a nap. Yeah, there's like a little sheltered area over there where I can rest and relax. I need to get there and a cave. Okay, this is cool. Cave in the mountain. Nip inside. I've got a torch and everything. So, okay. People are going to talk about me for years to come. Right, it's just a nice cave, and I'm very enthusiastic because of that. Level up at the bare minimum. So, sanity gain in events. Reduced cost on all terrain. But that's time, not energy. And energy is the big one, to be honest. Reduced energy cost on stone. I assume that means, yeah, whether you're climbing or walking. So, honestly, I'll take that. There might be a good... Yeah, there's a good stone path down... right here. I'm going to say good stone path. Screw it. Activate. Activate. So if I want to go here, then down here. Yeah. That there, that's much easier than just going, you know, down. That'd be a bad call. Do things step by flipping step. That's going to get me down off the peak. Right there. Just be careful. Make sure you plot a route sensibly. Need to get over there. Just need to not die. Bear in mind, I'm still in the death zone until I get below 6,000 meters. So, for the time being, oxygen is still going down. And it's almost night. You might think, well, John, you've done it. Hooray! Yes, night issue. It's almost night. Then it's going to start getting cold really fast. And if I sleep, then I'm going to start suffocating. So, that's going to be fun. That's going to be super fun right there. Okay, if I wanted to go the fastest direct route, it is... Where am I going? Like over there? Oh, yeah. Dangerous. Dangerous rock everywhere. Good. Good, good, good. I'm glad it's dangerous rock all the bloody way to the exit at this point. There is, however... There's treasure. Okay, there's a few events on the way. It's just... whether I want them or not, because this here is not the end. This is the first mountain of three. So, your equipment, your abilities, and to an extent, your stats, you carry forward. So, if I go over here... Okay, that's going to be tricky. Would I have to... I would have to retrace my steps down from there. Alternatively, there is... There's a treasure chest up there, but bloody hell is that... I could climb down there as well. That would be difficult. Honestly, I feel like just... Yeah, going directly down that way. But then again, I know there's a path. I know there's a path over here. I've seen the path over here. There's a path over in that direction. That path does not actually look that bad. It looks okay. I'm going to give it a go. Okay, we're going to go over in this direction. It's almost night. Which means... Well, I can just carry on in the night. But I'm going to have poor visibility. Like, very poor visibility. Okay, I'm going to activate careful steps. I'm going to use that to get up to the top. So I'm going slowly. But it's fine. And yeah, look at that. All of a sudden, I am getting... Ooh, careful steps also means my oxygen is now going down faster. Because I'm going slow. Okay, it's fine. Just need to get to the vault symbol over there. It's okay. Northern lights, that just gets me... Nothing of note. I mean, I'm inspired. Great. That is tricky. If I go that way, then round this way. Okay, there is a path there. Some of this is not looking hot. If I just rest here. Okay, activate my sleep here. If I have a long sleep, then my oxygen goes down a fair whack. I get my energy back. I think that's for the better. The oxygen is now going down. I'm potentially going to start, you know, hallucinating a bit before we're all done with this. But I've got my master mountaineering ability back, which is good. And if I run out of oxygen, I can just on the edge to make sure I don't suffer anything too bananas. But yeah, I'm done with careful for the time being. So we're just going to have to accept, yeah, the dangerous rocks here. There's a bunch of dangerous rocks. There's also... Is that... There's just a random thing over there. Could double back on myself to get that. Maybe don't bother with any of that nonsense. But energy's going down really fast right now. In fact, hang on. I'm on a lot of snow right now. Am I wearing the right shoes for snow, FYI? Yes, I'm wearing... No, that's ice. Okay, I don't have snowshoes. Which is unfortunate. So, what else can I do here? All I can really do is make myself more sane or more toasty, but that's okay. Now, I do have some canned food. But if I could not use it and thus keep it for next time, that'd be good. This was maybe not the most sensible route to follow. There's some deep snow. Okay, there is a snow bridge over, yeah, some little gap. If I take the safe option, my oxygen is starting to get dangerously low. I'm going to try and cross it. And, okay, I've caught my fall, but I did bang myself a bit. I've lost a tiny bit of health there. It's fine, because the oxygen is my bigger concern right now. And to be honest, I'll soon be out of the death zone. All right, I'm down to 6,018. As soon as we just go a tiny bit further down, that should be it. Seems I'm here. There we go. I've also found a cave. Didn't know there was going to be a cave here. I mean, I'll follow the cave and nothing there. Okay, nothing major at all. Don't bother sleeping. Just leave the cave. Didn't even realize there was an event down here, but there was. Okay. Everything is okay. It's all under control. I do have a master climber if I need it. To be honest, that's probably not a bad thing. I'm going to go here. I'm going to activate Master Climber, and I'm going to use that to get to here. Oh, blimey. Oh, there's a down route. Oh, okay. What if I don't want to do that? What if I'm not? Yeah, I feel like that's the better option. All right, I'm not going past all that dangerous snow. This is safer, because I'm not bad at climbing. But I'm now out of the death zone. My oxygen is now recovering. I'm now temporarily back in the death zone, but that's fine. I'm straight back out of the death zone, because everything is under control. Might be about to go back into it for a second. Nope, we're okay. I think we might be fine. I think we might have just about got away with that there. I was rather worried about the oxygen situation. But turns out it's all fine. It's all as it should be. And we're not in bad shape at the end of mountain number one. Now, do I want to... Okay, I don't actually have, my careful steps yet. So, unfortunately, I'm just crossing the dangerous ice and, gosh darn it, I start sliding down a glacier. So, I can sacrifice some energy or I can sacrifice... Ooh, okay, I can carefully let myself down the slope, but that's going to cost me a bit of temperature. Temperature's fine. It's now night. Screw it. Go. I don't care. Just get into the safe zone. And we should be golden. There we go. The first summit has been completed. Spectacular. But apparently I'm slightly bananas and I just want to push straight on to the next. But obviously things get a bit harder as time goes by. I'm starting to feel a bit of doubt. So I'm now suffering increased sanity loss when moving. Because that was a bit tough. So going forward, my sanity is now going down in a hurry. Mountain 1 complete, meaning I can now move over to Mountain 2. And yes, I get a choice of routes, where every single mountain has got its own little set of problems. So this one has got, yes, more events than usual, which is kind of good. Very rough terrain, so unfortunately I assume that means... oh wow, okay, massive energy cost on everything, just everything's more expensive. And in the event of a storm, then there's going to be even more trouble. Okay, alternatively, Route 2 looks a bit more friendly. So snow is nice and firm, easy to cross. However, very thin air. Oxygen's going to be a problem right from the lowland. Not just the death zone, just in general. And on top of that, there are, okay, also ghosts, but like bad ones. The other ghosts were fine. These ghosts are bad. So once again, sanity's just going to start ticking down. So oxygen and sanity, both in trouble. Alternatively, sturdy rock, but the night is going to be ludicrously cold, and when it's cold, it's gonna be very cold. I mean, I feel like that's gotta be the best option. So rock is good, but watch out for cold weather and nights, because they're gonna knacker the temperature. That there, that's the best option. Or is it?